Hello again, everybody, and welcome to Fathercraft's review of the Baby Beaba. So, what is the Baby Beaba? It's basically a 3-in-1 baby food maker. It's a steamer, a processor, and a reheater all wrapped into one tiny machine. Well, it's not that tiny, but you get the point. Okay, so what comes in the box? You've got your base unit, your bowl that comes assembled with the blade, the steaming and reheating basket, a spatula, which got a nice little holding spot right here in the base unit. And also a bowl lid. Assembly is super easy. You've got the base. You take your bowl, you stick it on the base. Click, you've got your steaming basket. Put it in the bowl, you close the lid, you press the steaming button, and you're off to the races. Okay, so how does it work? You fill the base unit with water, depending on what type of food you're steaming. For the more watery types of foods, there's the recipes call for a single dose of water. And for the starchier, more dense foods, the recipes call for 3 doses of water. And everything in between, 2 doses of water. What are the doses, you might ask? Well, the doses are found here on the bowl, which you probably can't see. Here's a close-up of it. So if you're making carrots, 3 doses, or sweet potatoes, 3 doses. Or butternut squash, 3 doses. As you can tell, I've only made food that require 3 doses of water. So after you've added your dose to the base unit, you chop up your food or your fruit or your veggie. It even does meat, I think. The instructions aren't very clear. They are listed in the reheating instructions, so you can definitely reheat meat in the Baby Beaba. As far as steaming the meat, I did some research on it and it's still not very clear. I've read that you can steam anything from chicken to fish, even ground up beef, but that kind of scares me a little bit. So I personally haven't tested out the steaming and pureeing of raw meats with the Beaba. How long does it take to cook? Like I said, there are 1, 2, or 3 doses. 1 dose takes about 5 minutes to steam, 2 doses, 10 minutes, and 3 doses, 15 minutes. And I tested the times and they're pretty accurate. It's not really a computerized mechanism that controls how long the steaming happens. It's just based on how much water is in the reservoir. So take that for what it's worth. What else? Pureeing. There's 2 blades. They seem powerful enough. Like I said, I've pureed butternut squash pretty easily. Carrots, simple enough. Sweet potatoes, pretty easily. I did find that you may potentially have to add more water after steaming when it comes to pureeing the food, which is not a big deal. What else do I got to say? Convenience factor. We do have a microwave, we do have a blender, and we do have a microwave, meaning we have a microwave to steam, a blender to puree, and a microwave to reheat food. But if you're short on space, and our kitchen kind of is lacking in the counter space, the Beaba puts all those things into one and doesn't take a huge footprint on your counter. The convenience, again, is pretty nice. It's not convenient, however, if you're looking to make food right away. I would not recommend doing this ad hoc on a whim. This is not a quick spur of the moment, I'm gonna make some food and then feed it to the kid. One night you decide, oh, I'm gonna make some butternut squash. I got it right here, it's been sitting on the counter for a week. I better use it before it goes bad. And then it comes the time when your baby's hungry and you're like, oh, sorry, baby, food is still hot. Gotta wait 10 minutes. Failed to mention that the package does come with a cool recipe book, Beaba Babycook cookbook. There are some starter recipes in here for you to kind of spice up the game a little bit. When I first saw recipe baby cook, I immediately thought of To Serve Man.
To Serve Man, it's a cookbook.
Anyway, when you're ready to graduate into fancier type recipes, there's some pretty cool things in here. Also, This doesn't have to be strictly for baby food if you like making smoothies. Steam, blend, freeze. Boom. I think that's it. I think I've covered everything. Well, actually, that's not it. I do have more to say. Here it is. I unfortunately left out a big piece of this video, namely giving you some final thoughts on the Baby Beaba. The Beaba Babycook. Anyway, moving on. So what are the final thoughts? Let's get to it. Pros. One, I love the 3-in-1 aspect to the Beaba Babycook, the steaming, the blending, and the reheating all in one relatively small piece of equipment. Despite it only having three main functions, it does those functions really well. So I never had to worry about food being under-steamed or undercooked, or the blender not being able to handle whatever food was in there. I only used the reheating functions a few times, but it did its job. So I started noticing more the amount of food that was being left out and going unused, and started thinking, well, can I use that food and throw it in the baby cook and see what kind of concoctions I can come up with? So that was fun. It resulted in throwing away less food or composting less food. In that sense, it's kind of like a reverse garbage disposal or something. You got food that you know is sitting out and you're gonna go to waste, pop it in the old baby cook and see what kinds of concoctions you can come up with. Assembly for me is a very important aspect to whether or not I'm going to enjoy or want to buy something like this. And as I said in the video, it comes basically fully assembled. All right, cons. What are some of the cons? This is not so much a con, it's just that I don't feel like the Beaba Babycook has enough in it or to it that's gonna push the everyday parent who can go either way on whether or not they wanna start getting into making their own baby food. Another con, and I don't know if there's any way around this, the prep work takes a lot of time. You've got to clean and peel, and it takes time to steam, and it takes time to puree, and it takes time to cool down. This is something you have to plan out in advance, but make sure you have enough time to get everything done if you're wanting to make the food. Like I said, I don't know if there's any way around it, but that's just the nature of this beast. Some functions that I wish it had that it doesn't. One being, there's no indication letting you know how much time is left in the steaming process. You can't see inside the reservoir, so you don't know how much water is or is not in the reservoir. So that is kind of a big deal, in that if you put too much water in, you could overcook your food, or if you don't put enough water in, you can undercook your food, obviously. So overall verdict, what did I think? Meh, it's just a fun thing to have. It's definitely not necessary or vital that you have this. But you know, if you're looking to get more into making your own baby food, I would say this is a great place to start. Thank you again for watching this review and for putting up with me continually saying the name of this product wrong. I won't get it right ever. Make sure to visit fathercraft.com to check out other reviews that we've done. We appreciate your time. Thanks.